Hello. I'm going to show you how to get petroleum, do petroleum deliveries in my warehouse deliveries mod. First, you get your tanker, whatever you have. You need to hang on. Sorry, I've got a dolly out there. Let me just put the dolly away. Purchase parts, and then you want to find your load. Swap out with the career mode compatible one. It doesn't replace the old one because there's some finicky things behind the scenes. Little quick hacks. So you want to swap it out, and then you fetch your truck. You fetch your trailer dolly. And then what you want to do is you want to drive all the way here. There's a few duplicate locations because I actually made my own, and then I later found out that the BeamNG devs also made their own, and so I just kind of just copied over some stuff. Now so these are something you want to do that. Devs left those work in progress locations. You just drive to that location. You need to have the right layout, otherwise it won't load the petroleum. Like, you won't be able to load petroleum in the regular cargo bay, and you won't be able to load any regular cargo petroleum bay. So to listen to my annoying keyboard. Now, as you can see, we have zero items here. We can cycle through others if you're on top of multiple ones. If you get the stupid ass annoying bug, thank you, dev, saw that. Just press F5, wait for it, and then try again. I need to switch. That's right. And then you just load them up. Sometimes if your thing doesn't like show up, like down here, your trailer, you probably need to drive further forward. Turbo burger, that's fine. Because of some weird hacks I did to liquid simulation, due to limitations, there is no way to get the weight of a node to determine the spring strength. And so, what actually happens is before the race nodes inside the tanks would drop and just drag on the ground. And so what I've done is I've disabled contacts. They actually drop, and due to weird mathematics, it shouldn't really affect you too much unless you like, jump off the ground. But otherwise, yeah, it's got a lot of inertia to it. It'll be a bit weird to drive with, but devs, please provide a way for me to grab the weight of a node so I can get the perfect beam strength and damping effects. It's currently this is possible. Whoops, stole my vehicle. Start. That's just how it works in real life, like trying things like that. And then it's gonna say it's got a lower range box, and then it says it's got a range box and a splitter, so splitter looks like a lower range. Thank you. I mean, it looks a bit weird doing it like this, but with this bloody BS, border thing over there, crashing into this as well. I mean, where can you really put it? You can probably put it down here, but you have to reverse back in. That's a bit difficult doing the road train. So, you know, I figured the best location is just right here. But it doesn't look too out of place. I could put it down here. Oh yeah, that's just the way I'm doing this. Because if there's no fuel and deposit box. Anyway. Anyway, yeah, that's it really. Fuel missions are actually very broken in terms of how much money they make, considering how easy it is. So the only limiting factor I put in is they only respawn once every 10 minutes or 5 minutes. And that's a probability thing, so it's like sometimes you might sit there for an hour and you won't get anything. So yeah, just do your regular mission, do your regular daily missions, and then come back, check this once in a while. And you might be able to make a quick buck. I mean, it's only been like 1 hour since I started this test, and I made 150k. So it's about 50 to 100k per run. So I tried to reduce the value of the fuel and stuff like that, but it's still makes you a fuckload of money. Turns out I went through the lower code a while back and the devs haven't even implemented that feature, so the worth value parameter for delivery items does not do anything yet. They made it compatible with custom cargo types like fuel and custom containers like fuel containers. So BeamNG devs do whatever they want, so. Hope you enjoyed this video.